In this video, I'm having a look at the new Jackery Explorer 2000 Plus. It's a portable battery station that has a capacity of 2,042 watt hours. So 2 kilowatt hours, but you can increase the capacity. I've got one of their expandable batteries here, which is called the Battery 2000 Plus. You can add 5 of these plus the original battery station, giving us a total capacity of 12 kilowatt hours. Absolutely huge. Output-wise, very good. One of the more powerful units that I am covering here in the channel, 3,000 watts. So it has solar input that you can charge with their panels if you get 6 of them at 200 watts. And you can fully charge this station alone in just 2 hours. AC charging, well, in 100 minutes, you get it up to 80%, and it's 2 hours to fully charge it. Now it's using LFP battery cells, which are really the battery cells you want to be going for because they're long lasting, they're safer, they handle higher temperatures better. And after 4,000 cycles, the Explorer 2000 Plus will still be at 70% capacity. And those cells are good for 10 years.
In the box you get this. It's a pouch that has our accessories. We've got the power cable, a car charging cable, and then 2 adapters for the DC plugs, the input. And if you've got the extended battery, then you're going to get one of these very large gauge cables with the connectors there to connect the 2 battery packs.
Now we've got a really good build quality here with the Explorer 2000 Plus. ABS style plastic to it, but it is UV resistant, flame retardant, and drop resistant to the materials. Now there's no sharp edges here. Power on, our screen can be made out in direct sunlight. We've got our DC side of things here, the AC, both of them have a button to turn them on and off. So the car cigarette lighter port here, or the car accessory port, that's DC 12 volts, 10 amps. We've got 2 type A ports here that do support quick charge 3, 18 watts each. And then the type C ports supporting power delivery are 100 watts max, both of them. So that's 200 watts in total. Now other brands split that between both of them, but not here with Jackery. And then the AC side, we have the 3 ports here, EU plugs that I've got, and they do support 3000 watts in total. So not each of them, but in total there. So you can have say 1500 and 1500 coming out of 2 of those. Along the back is where you will find our inputs. So we have the AC input there, which is going to charge it in 2 hours to 100%, or in just 100 minutes up to 80%. So it is very quick with those LFP cells that it is using. They're good for, of course, 4,000 cycles or 10 years. And after the 4,000 cycles, it's still got 70% capacity. DC inputs there, and there is this AC input reset if you happen to overload it. So there is an overload protection, which all of them need. Great to have that there. And then on the other side, the DC expansion port. So this is where you can expand the capacity that I talked about in the intro. So you can add an additional 5 2-kilowatt portable expandable batteries, giving us in total combined with this unit here, then 12 kilowatts. That's a lot if you needed that kind of capacity. So it's a very solid cable, as it should be. And you'll see that it's labeled here A. And I've got the A plug there too. So it's very clear. You need to push it in. You've got a clip at the top that you need to push. And it takes a little bit of effort. And then once it's in place, it clicks in. And that is not going anywhere. The B plug then goes into our expandable battery here, which is the Pack 2000 Plus. Now it's got its own DC inputs here, which is great. Means you can charge the expandable batteries by themselves. You don't have to use the Explorer 2000 Plus at all. And the input here is exactly the same as the main unit. So it is 60 volts, 12 amps max there for our solar input or charging input DC. So both the portable battery station and the expanded battery pack do have ventilation. So they've got fans inside, active cooling, BMS, which is our battery monitoring system there that's constantly checking on the temperatures to ensure that it is safe, it's not going to overheat. And if it does get too hot, that's when the safety kicks in and powers it down. The extended battery packs, these are 18 kilos, so they're a lot more manageable. And yes, you can sit it on top of the portable battery station. Now there's 2 ways you can gauge the battery status of the portable packs, and that is just the screen here with its power on button, or you can use the application, which I will show you later in the video. And I've got a perfect day here too to be able to test out my solar panel and see what kind of charging rate I can get. Now, Jackery do sell their own 200 watt portable foldable solar panels, but this thing here is a lot more potent. This is 450 watts maximum. So I'll connect it up and we'll take a look at those charging rates. Currently charging at 382 watts here. You can see it's telling me I've got 4 hours remaining to fully charge this portable battery station. So that's on par really with other battery stations I've reviewed. Although some of those units I've seen an input wattage of 400 and slightly over. The best I've seen so far is 392 watts. So both the Explorer 2000 Plus and the Battery Pack 2000 Plus can be charged with the included cable in your car, but be warned, it's really slow. Let's take a look at the charge rates that I can get from my car. So currently charging around almost 100 watts. It's going to take 17 hours to finish off charging this battery to go from 30% to 100. So that's a long time. This really, for me, is only for emergency situations. And when you finish getting it out of, say, the boot or trunk of a car, isn't too difficult because it does have some really good handholds either side of it. Plastic quality is good, as I pointed out before. And it does weigh 28 kilos, almost. So it is a bit heavy to get in and out, but good thing we do have this, of course, the extendable handle. So that pulls out like so. Good quality to it, and the wheels are very solid. So this allows me just to pull it along as if it was a suitcase or a briefcase. So what can you use a powerful portable battery station such as this one for? Well, 3,000 watts, that's a lot. I mean, it's gonna be perfect for motorhome, RV owners, people that are off-grid, and power tools. Well, you've got a huge range of power tools you can use up to that 3,000 watts. So this here, like an edge trimmer, I think it's only a max that it peaks at is about 600 watts. So it's not going to be a problem at all. I'll just test it out. So you've got so many uses with this. It was probably a perfect unit here for tradesmen too that do use powerful tools. Now, if you do have a second unit, there's a special cable you can get, and you can get up to then 6,000 watts maximum output. Power drill, for example. Not a problem. And then if you wanted to, say, vacuum your car outdoors and you don't have a power plug that's close by and accessible, then you can just use your portable Jackery Explorer 2000 Plus here. The 2000 watts, not a problem for this unit.
So now it's time to really load it up, put it under some stress, test out that inverter with some of my low tests. So I've got it charging at the moment and it's about 1700 watts, just over. And this is where you do hear the fan quite a bit when it's charging at the fastest rate possible. So it's telling me it's got 1.1 hours left to fully charge. So the fan on the right is pulling the cool air in. This fan here on the left is the loud one that's pushing the warm air out. And you can feel it's a little warm. And here's a sample of it, what you can expect fan-wise. My little hairdryer test. So I've got the 2,200 watt hairdryer here. What I've noticed is when I pull really large loads on the Explorer 2000 Plus, the charging rate will drop right off, right down to about 200 watts. So watch this. So drop down to 200 watts, the fan cuts out and becomes quiet again, and here it is, charging again. So it can run and charge heavy appliances at the same time, as well as charging itself. So it's good there, it's passed this little load test, but I'm going to step it up now. Just plugged in a kettle to boil water. Now there's a lot of these battery stations that just can't boil water. So running both of them, we'll see how it handles it. Now I'm gonna go over the 3000 watts here and I do expect it to trip out. It has to do that, overload protection. So here we go. 2200 watts, not a problem. Doesn't sound that loud at all when you're not charging. So I'm not charging at the moment. Now the hairdryer, it will end up tripping out. Okay, so it got to 4,000 and something or other watts, and then it cut out, and that's great. That's the overload protection, and after a while, it's going to reset itself, but I can just turn it off and then back on again, and it should then have reset. And it reset itself, and I'm back to now boiling water, which you can do here with the Explorer 2000 Plus. And like all good models, it does have UPS. So I'm going to pull the power plug out here. So currently it's charging. That's the only time it really makes the loud fan noises, when it's charging. So turn the hair dryer on, pull this out, and we should see it just swap over from grid power to then the battery power. Now it should do this in 20 milliseconds. So it's very quick. So hair dryer on. And that was very quick. So the UPS function is working well.
So all up, this is a great unit here from Jackery, the Explorer 2000 Plus, and the possibility to expand upon your needs there of just how many kilowatts you need, kilowatt hours. So the original model here is the 2024 watt hours, but then you can keep adding these modules here to bring it right up to that 12 kilowatt hours, which is fantastic capacity there if you do need that. Now this unit here is heavy. It's almost 28 kilos, that's the downside to it, but we've got a good hand grip on it, and they have the handle and the wheels, as I showed you. Makes it a lot more easier to move about. This is around 18 kilos, and I love the fact that it can be charged just by itself with solar, with the DC charging, but there's no AC charging plug on it, which is unfortunate. You'll still need to plug it into this unit in order to charge that. We'll charge them both at the same time. Now, if you need more than the 3000 watts output from this, which is one of the more powerful ones I've covered, then you can get a lead that's very similar to the orange one that connects them, but you need two of the units then. And that can bring you up to the 6000 watts. You double your output then, which is gonna power everything, which is really good that we have at least these kind of options. Now, they've got the battery management system in this, monitoring the temperatures to ensure it doesn't overheat. Plastic quality seems great, so drop resistant plastic, flame retardant plastic, UV resistant, and the best part for me is they are now using LFP battery cells. So 4,000 cycles, it drops down to 70%. It's going to be good for 10 years. Even if you cycle it and use it every day, it will still be fine because they're the best quality cells really you can get for portable battery packs such as this, or battery stations. Well, they like to call them solar generators, which I find quite funny, but that's how they market them as, because you can of course charge them via solar. So the charging times are really good. They're 100 minutes to get it to 80%, and then 2 hours to fully charge. Car charging is an option, but it is very slow, and solar, you've got that option too, and you can use their portable solar panels too if you wanted to. So really the only downside to this model here for me is the price tag. Like all of them, they are expensive units. So all out, what you're looking at that I've covered in this video, so that is the Explorer 2000 Plus plus the Battery 2000 Plus. This is around, at the time of this video, about 3,700 euros. So yes, pricey. But when you look at the competition, they're about the same price. However, they don't offer the 3,000 watts output. A lot of them are 2,000 or 2,200. It's very powerful here. And fan noise is another thing I like about Jackery's products. It's not as loud as the competition. So thank you so much for watching my review here of the Jackery Explorer 2000 Plus and the Pack 2000 Plus here, expandable battery.